In this episode, we meet Auron, a warrior from Final Fantasy, and he's dead. On Cosplay Theatre, see what happens when things don't go quite as planned during a self-defense class. On Cosplay with Constance, R2 gets an upgrade. Then, we meet the cosplayer and prop builder behind the video game character. Learn about using Plasti Dip on Cosplay Tips with Tiki. And finally, a bonus interview with actor Michael Traynor, who played Nicholas on The Walking Dead. Suit up, it's time for some cosplay.
Welcome to Captain Kyle's Cosplay Spotlight. As always, I am Captain Kyle, and as always, you are...
Did I have a line?
Do you have a name?
Tiki, Two Flower. Yeah, that's my handle now.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You don't look like her.
I don't? Oh, no. I dyed my hair and I extensions. Ah, trying to normalize my look.
Yeah.
More marketable.
You know, I'm just going to call you Constance.
That's a little shorter, so we can go with that.
Yeah, we'll go with Constance. Do you know Constance, TK, Tiki, whoever you think you are?
You can call me Constance for short.
Constance for short. I have always wanted to be a warrior. But, you
know. Is that your final fantasy, to be a warrior?
Anyways, I wouldn't mind being a warrior, but I am not a warrior. But I know
you're not.
You said that too quickly. However, we are going to bring a warrior onto the stage. I would like to bring on Auron the Warrior. That is a big sword.
Thank you.
I bet you hear that a lot.
You don't. He does.
I do. You don't.
True. I try to keep my sword more hidden, and it's really easy to hide. Anyway, welcome to the show. Thanks for taking time out of your busy schedule of...
Being dead.
I imagine that would take up a lot of time, being dead. Pretty much a full-time job, being dead.
It's better than being with those annoying two people I'm with.
Captain Kyle and Constance?
I'm pretty annoying, so I get that a lot.
Jacked.
So, I hear, before you were dead, you were a warrior monk.
Yes. I was the best of the best.
The best of the best?
Yes.
Is that like, do you get a trophy?
No, I just get looked upon as being really good.
That's very cool. As a warrior, you're no longer a monk. Did you have to take like certain vows as a monk? Like,
yeah, I told the head priest I would not marry her daughter.
Ah, that would kind of be a bummer. Did you at least, you know, go on dates, go steady? You know,
no.
That? No. Couldn't do that?
I was straight for the cause. Defeating monsters, saving the innocents.
So you are straight. Okay. So I understand that for many years you took care of someone named Titus.
Yes.
Can you tell us about this Titus?
He's like the annoying nephew with ADHD.
Like Constance.
Yes. He cries at a lot of things. His dad wasn't the greatest. He was actually terrible. So he cries a lot. Runs to his mom a lot. Well, until his mother passed away.
Sounds like a handful.
Yes.
And why did you take on this responsibility of helping out this Titus person?
Jack told me to look after his kid for him. That's his father.
Ah.
Many a times I just wanted to take his little head and just, you know, just drown it in a little pile of, like, toilet water or something. Just, like, flush him down.
I understand. I've had nephews like that. So, you said you're dead. What is it like being dead? And how can you be dead and here?
You don't feel like you're decaying.
I'm not.
I'd say you don't smell like, but that might not just...
In my world, when you die, you can choose to either to move on or just not and just get back up. Of course, you don't have a heartbeat, you don't get hungry, you don't have any drive.
So, there are downsides.
Yes.
Because the whole, you know, I don't think I'm going to die today. Oh, you just shot me? I'm not going to die.
Yeah, I can't feel pain anymore.
Well, that's kind of cool. What exactly do you carry in that bottle, by the way?
I carry rum.
Rum? So that is where the rum's gone. Yeah, you might want to guard that bottle from Constance.
It's empty.
I drank it all already. I can smell the rum from here, okay? How are you supposed to not drink the rum? I don't...
This is like oil for dead people to actually taste.
We're almost out of time, but before we go, what are your plans for the future? I mean, do you have plans as a dead person?
I was going to say, yeah, do dead people have plans? Do you just... Or 401k.
I'm going to see how many people I can help out in the world. And then if I get bored, I'll just go into the afterlife again.
So you can, like, commute?
I can.
Back and forth.
Some people shouldn't and can't, which makes me happy. This is my vacation.
So a vacation from the afterlife?
A vacation from Jack.
Yeah. Do you have to get, like, a pass, like a SEPTA pass?
No.
Is it a monthly thing?
No.
No? Tokens? No. All right. Well, thank you so much. We're just about out of time, but we're going to come back after these segments. Thanks so much. Welcome, students. Today we have a special guest instructor in our self-defense class. This is the great warrior Auron, and he will be giving us some tips and answering your questions. So take it away, Auron.
Greetings. Any questions?
Hi, big fan. What do you do if someone grabs your arm?
Well, I'll demonstrate for you. If you would.
Not a problem.
First, you would kick out his leg. Grab his arm, and then just gently knee him into the stomach.
Yeah, that great technique. Just a little easier next time.
You know. It was easy.
Okay, next question.
Okay, but what do you do if someone gets you in a headlock?
Very good question.
All right, but go easy this time.
Of course, I always go easy.
All right.
Now first, you're going to want to throw off this balance.
And hold it up his arm, hold it down a little, and then, you know, kick him to the ground.
Yeah.
You should see what I'd do if it was real.
That was great.
But never stomp him on the ground. That's bad for their shins.
Yeah, that was great. Thanks so much. You can go.
Oh, but I got another question.
Oh.
What happens if somebody gets you by the throat? What are you supposed to do?
Excellent question.
I'd like to know.
I don't want
to.
Oh, trust me. You'll be fine. You'll barely feel any pain.
Easy this time. Easy, right? Easy?
Oh, well, I always do easy.
No, really easy. Please. You got to promise to be easy.
Yes. I will try.
All right.
There you go. Now, first thing you're going to want to do is grab his arm as hard as you can. And then, you know, if you have a good arm, just break it a little bit, pop out of the thing. And then. You okay? And then you kick him. Oh. Here, let me help you up. There you go.
Out!
Any other questions?
Get out! You promised me that was not easy. You dislocated my shoulder, almost broke my wrist. You get out.
Almost doesn't count.
You said you'd go easy. You broke your word.
No, I didn't.
You broke your... Get out.
I never break my word.
You did right there.
I did not break my word. I used my strong arm.
This is just an instructing class, and you went full out. Get out.
I did not go full out. My student's more resilient than you are.
Look, buddy, I don't care. You broke your word. You said you were going to go easy. Get out. I don't deal with oath breakers.
Let's take care of this. By the gods.
By the gods. Are you like...
I challenge you.
You want to fight me?
No, I want to beat you.
All right. If that's the way it's going to be. And I'll take these too!
Oh, I can't be seen without my glasses. My glasses.
Ha! Beat you. even took glasses.
It's a stupid game anyway.
Geek Girls Castle has nerdy skirts with a drawstring waist and large pockets that fit an iPhone 6 Plus, plus drawstring bags for dice, makeup, electronics, and more. Check them out at geekgirlscastle.com.
Hi everyone, we're here with Cosplay with Constance with another extreme cosplay. What are you cosplaying as?
R2-D2000.
Nice. It's amazing. Now walk us through how you made your costume, because it's a pretty extreme.
EVA foam, all EVA foam. Just took about 6 months to build it. I got a screwdriver in here. It's been a Gatling gun. Shield, TIE fighter, shield. Got pretty good mobility. Legs. Got speaker system, if my daughter would pay that. But she's over there lost in her own little world. No. Pretty much that's it. I mean, it's mostly all EVA foam. A little bit of PVC pipe and for the frame, and that's it.
Were the lightsabers in the back too? Did you get a shot of those too? Those are really cool. No, did you make this for me? Is it mine now? Can I have it?
I
can have
one more contest and then you can have it.
I think I would die in that. Is it really, really warm in there?
Oh yeah. But I got fans. The spinning lights in the back, that's all fans. And then I got fans in the headpiece.
Very, very smart. Now, how long have you been cosplaying? How many years have you been doing this?
I guess about six and a half years.
Yeah. Do you always make your own costumes or do you buy some as well?
Yeah, always, yep. I started with it was a zombie Captain America, and I just kind of moved my way along, did Lobo, and I started getting, Transformers. Yeah, it's pretty solid. I mean, I can take a punch.
No. It hurt. This one took you about 6 months to get to make. Do they usually all take about 6 months? Because you have some major extreme build.
Nah, usually 2 months average. But I took my time on this one. I wanted to really do this one up right.
How long does it take you to get into a costume like this?
Well, with my daughter there, it takes about 15 minutes. My other daughter takes about 5 minutes.
Are you playing favorites?
Yes, I am. That's my little baby.
It's really awesome. Now, what builds are you working on now, or are you taking a little breather?
I'm getting ready to start Spider-Man. It's an ectoskeleton Spider-Man, and I'm actually be Spider-Man inside of it. So, yeah, it's going to be another big build. Oh, yeah.
So, Mike, what other cosplays do you have?
I got Omega Supreme for Transformers. I got Clayface that I used here last year and won Best Villain. I got Twiggy from Buck Rogers in 21st Century. Let's see, what else have I made? Thor Frog, which I wore yesterday. Got to meet Walt Simonson in it. It was epic. Yeah, he even stopped in the middle of what he was doing to just take a picture with me. God, the list goes on and on and on. I got more.
I mean, 6 years, you kind of do build up quite a repertoire.
Yeah.
Now, for people who are just starting to get started in cosplay and armor builds and working with EVA foam, do you have any advice?
Just, I don't know. Use your imagination. Think outside of the box. Just take your time with it. Don't be in a hurry.
But aren't you kind of in a box?
Har.
All right, well, thanks, Mike, for taking your time to talk with us. Back to you, Kyle.
Welcome back. We are now here with the cosplayer who is behind that fearsome warrior. Sir, if you would be so kind as to introduce yourself.
My name is William Henry Lyford IV.
You're alive, though, right? Not like your character? His home is almost
dead. We definitely know where the rum's gone.
Mm-hmm.
So, welcome to the show, William.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. That is an awesome costume.
Thank you.
I could say you might want to dial back on the accuracy by not bringing rum into Constance's presence.
It's gone. It's gone.
It wasn't gone until you got it.
I think it played out well.
She might be quieter. Might be. So what inspired you to start into this wonderful world of cosplay?
My friend Carl invited me to go to Otakon. And I was looking at the conventions, like, people are dressed up. I don't want to act like me. I'm boring. So then I looked at rather a bunch of costumes, and I saw that I wanted to cosplay someone my height, because nobody wants to see a 7'8" Naruto running around or something like that.
Or like one of the seven dwarves. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. So I chose an Auron costume. I knew a little bit of sewing, so I ordered pieces online. And then after I got them, realized I didn't know how to sew.
That would be a wake-up call.
This is the fourth costume of the same one. But I still wore it until I sat down and... Nothing okay. Like being in the middle of Baltimore, in the middle of a convention, and my pants crack, rip open, my ass is just hanging out. But.
But.
But. Did you say but?
But. This is a but. As gun.
Family but.
That's fine. Ass is okay to say.
Asses?
Ass is okay to say.
If ass was okay to say, why didn't you tell me this before? I feel like I missed a lot of moments where I could have said ass, and I just thought I couldn't because this is family friendly.
Once per show. Okay. What other characters do you have?
I have an Angeal. Most of my characters are from Final Fantasy. I made a 1/3 scale Malboro. It's 11 feet tall, 14 feet wide. I cosplay as Mr. Torg from Borderlands 2. I cosplay as Sandbag from Smash Brothers. Everybody gets to beat me up. It's great.
I can relate. I've been a red shirt from Star Trek. Go on.
I got beat up and get killed.
Yeah, so I actually go a little further than you. I get killed. Go on, please.
Martial arts male, Ukita, a lot of other ones I can't think of right now.
That's very cool. Looking at this really huge sword.
Sorry, it's the first time Kyle's seen one that big, so.
We're not that unfamily friendly. Okay, so.
I was just talking about swords. When you.
I've seen bigger.
No, this is a really awesome... You made this yourself?
Yes.
And how did you make this marvelous device that I'm about to hit Constance with?
When I went to conventions, or when I was reading up on the conventions, I saw that a lot of people make their stuff out of cardboard and stuff, which isn't a bad idea, but a lot of kids like to go, ha-ha, poof, and they all look like then just like really sad elves. So I wanted to build something so when a guy went like this, ha ha, he would cry, I wouldn't. Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
That makes sense. So have you a reputation of causing other people to cry when they come after your props? So.
I've had one situation where another cosplayer actually derailed my large costume and it collapsed on me.
Ouch. That's gotta hurt.
Yeah. It's a bunch of steel and metal.
Ouch.
Steel and wood. Metal is steel.
Yes, yes. Not all metal is steel, but steel is metal.
Yeah.
So you make a lot of props, and it sounds like the costumes you make can be quite elaborate. So how long have you been making these?
I've been making them since I started cosplaying, since I started going to conventions, which is 2008. I've made over 1,000 wooden and resin props.
Wow.
And then I stopped because it was started to become less of a hobby for me and more work. So I just make them into a select few.
That's cool. You don't want to turn your hobby into something that becomes too much of a job.
Yeah. But most of the stuff is resin, wood, and steel.
Very cool. I think we're just about out of time, so we're going to go to another segment. We're going to come back and say goodbye so you can get your jug back. I'm sorry that it's going to be empty, but we'll be back after this segment. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Tiki Twoflower, and welcome to Cosplay Tips with Tiki. Today, I'm going to talk to you about Plasti Dip. Now, some of you may already know Plasti Dip and love it and use it on a regular basis. Some of you may have heard the word Plasti Dip before, and some of you may have no idea what I'm talking about. So I'm going to inform all of you today. Plasti Dip is a rubberized coating. It's actually designed for use originally on cars, but crafters and cosplayers have realized that this is a really awesome, versatile material that you can use for your cosplays. It comes in a spray or in a paint-on in a big can. And the spray is very similar to using spray paint, especially in that you want to be very cautious when you're using Plasti Dip. Make sure that you're using it in a well-ventilated area, preferably outside or in a garage, something like that. And you should be wearing a mask or respirator and gloves when you're using Plasti Dip. So what would you want to use Plasti Dip for? Well, the thing about Plasti Dip is it comes in a variety of colors. So you can simply get whatever color you'd like something to be. You can buy it in that Plasti Dip and spray or paint it on. Or the really cool thing about Plasti Dip is that it creates a water-resistant, paintable finish on almost any surface. It's very popular to use in crafting EVA foam armor for cosplayers, but it can also be used to cover cardboard, craft foam, plastic, even fabric can be covered in Plasti Dip. The only things that you can't really use Plasti Dip for are things that might have a reaction like styrofoam. Basically, anything that you can spray paint, you can Plasti Dip. What's even cooler about Plasti Dipping something is once you get a couple of coats on there, as I said, it's water resistant, it's paintable, and you don't actually even need to use a primer or a finisher. So I'm going to show you one of the things that I've used Plasti Dip for so that you can just get an idea. And this is a piece of armor I made. And of course, I was able to paint it many different colors. I started off with a solid Plasti Dip base, but this is actually made of plastic cones, craft foam, EVA foam, and Nerf darts. I used four different materials on this, and Plasti Dip gave me a way to paint everything and have it look uniform. So honestly, Plasti Dip is one of my favorite cosplay discoveries of all time, and I highly recommend giving it a shot. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
This episode was sponsored in part by Peppermint Cosplay Knives, your source for high-quality, con-safe replica blades. Visit them today.
Hey everyone, this is Captain Kyle. I'm here at Monster Mania Con. I'm here with talented actor Michael Traynor. How are you doing today?
I'm well, man. I'm well. Thank you for having me here.
Hey, my pleasure. So, how are you enjoying Monster Mania Con?
Oh, it's full of monsters and full of mania, so it's everything you'd want. It fulfills on the promise of the title, man. Come out and join the fun next time you can.
How many cons do you usually go to?
It depends. I try and fit it in when I can in my schedule. It's always a genuine delight to kind of come out there and meet the fans and meet people who want to express how much they hated my character for such a long time. And they do it with these wonderful smiles on their faces because the show just has a great impact on folks, you know? And it's a lovely thing to be a part of that and to be reminded of what little role I played in the big oeuvre of Walking Dead land.
Getting back to the convention circuit, you look around and you see people in costume. Mm-hmm. You've probably seen me in costume sometimes. I only half see you because I only have one eye. Right. What do you think about these cosplayers?
I think it's awesome. I mean, it's kind of fantastic. It's that spirit of dress up that you had when you were a kid, but now you have the money to actually like go and get the costume and to be a part of it. And I think it's a wonderful reflection of being passionate about something. That's what I think these cons are. And what's really great about it is the passion that it captures of the fan base for a particular genre or a particular show or just to kind of be it for a second. And the glee, it's kind of a generous thing also, because we see you guys, you know, we're here behind our booths and we're saying hello to the fans who come to us, but oftentimes you guys are out wandering around, just adding an atmosphere of celebration. And you guys are so generous with your time, and you pose and you get involved in it. And I've seen you guys start staging things. And you know, when I can, when I'm wandering around in my doofy ways, I hop in as I'm allowed to. And
as you did yesterday.
Yes, exactly. And it's just a really fun thing to do. And so I applaud it. And secretly, it's one of the things I love coming to these things for, is to see that.
If you were to dress and cosplay yourself, who would you be?
Jeepers, that's a good question. I've never thought about that. So sometimes I'll in between like reading scripts and stuff, they're all like very heady and or dark, and so I like to watch cartoons, and I'd either want to be Steven from Steven Universe, little pudgy guy with a little gem in my belly just wandering around, or I was watching Thundercats recently, and I remembered when I was a kid how I thought Tigra was the coolest girl around. So maybe now that I've cut my hair, I wouldn't be such a good Tigra, but that would be a fun one to do.
So where can people find you on like social networking or social media so that they can find out about these new features that are coming down the road?
I am at Traynorland, Traynorland, like Disneyland, but cooler. No.
But less nice.
But less nice. Yeah, like edgy Disneyland. It's Traynorland on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat, although I've rarely snapped or chatted on it.
All right, well, Michael, thank you so much.
Pleasure.
And everyone, thanks for watching. And as always, have fun and cosplay on.
Thanks so much for watching. That's all we have for this episode.
Cheers, guys. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can have it.
Thank you, William, so much for coming on and showing us your awesome cosplay.
Thank you.
It's been fun.
And next time, try not to get my co-host drunk.
No promises.
You can never promise with her. Anyways, we hope to see you on the con floor somewhere. In the meantime, have fun and cosplay on.
Interested in cosplay, but you're not sure where to start? Get my book, Elements of Cosplay, The Costume and Beyond, available at Amazon.com. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, subscribe to our channel so you can see our latest videos right away. Our next episode features Steve Urkel from Family Matters and will be released on March 27th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Hope to see you on the con floor. Bye for now.